Good evening.
Good evening.
And welcome. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Our procession this evening, angels we have heard on high. Please rise.
Thank you. God, who lighted us year by year as we waited hope for our redemption, grant that as we joyfully welcome your only begotten Son as our Redeemer, we may also merit to face him confidently when he comes again as our Judge, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
You shall be called by a new name, pronounced by the mouth of the Lord. You shall be a glorious crown in the hand of the Lord, a royal diadem held by your God. No more shall people call you forsaken, or your land desolate, but you shall be called my delight, and your land is blessed, for the Lord delights in you, and make your hand your land is blessed. As a young man marries a virgin, your builder should marry you. And as a rich bridegroom rejoices in his bride, so shall your God rejoice in you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Baptism of repentance to all the people of Israel. do you suppose that I am? I am not he. Behold, one is coming after me. I am not worthy to unfasten the sandals of his feet. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
This is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. When his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found with child through the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her husband, since he was a righteous man, yet unwilling to expose her to shame, decided to divorce her quietly. Such was his intention when, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary, your wife, into your home, for it is through the Holy Spirit that this child has been conceived in her. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet, "Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke, he did as the angel of the Lord had commanded him. He took his wife into his home. He had no relations with her until she bore a son, and he named him Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
There's an old story that I always like to tell on Christmas Eve, and I think it originally was told by Paul Harvey, the old radio announcer, although at least maybe he quoted it. But there was a farmer on Christmas Eve. You know, this farmer was a good man, but he was not particularly religious. You know, he lived by the golden rule, but this whole Christianity thing did not make a whole lot of sense to him. He believed in God, but the idea of God becoming man just sounded more to him like a comforting myth than anything else. So every Christmas Eve, his wife and kids would get all bundled up and they would go off to midnight mass, and he would stay home and he'd listen to Christmas music on the radio. One particular Christmas Eve, his family had already left for mass and he was left alone in the house. It was a very cold, snowy, windy night. And as he listened to the radio, he looked out the window at the falling snow, and he saw a few birds who were caught up in the wind and the snow. They were clearly disoriented because of the harsh weather. They'd lost their bearings, and the farmer thought, they're going to freeze to death. The barn was just a few yards away. If they just flew into the barn, they would be safe. He kept watching, and finally he couldn't stand it any longer, and he grabbed the broom. And he went outside and he tried to shoot the birds into the barn, but they just became more confused. He thought to himself, if only I could become a bird, just for a minute, I could lead the birds to safety. And then it hit him. That's what the incarnation is. It's God becoming human in order to show us how to live and to lead us to safety. Over the 24 hours of Christmas, there are several masses, and each one of them has their own set of readings. And in one of them, the prophet Isaiah says, "The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone." And in another one of the readings, the letter to Titus, Paul says that the grace of God has appeared to train us to reject godless ways and worldly desires and to live devoutly in this age. Christ is our Savior, and Christ saves us in many different ways. I mean, certainly he saves us by his suffering and death, but he also saves us through his life. He saves us through his teaching. He taught us so many things: to love our neighbor, to forgive our enemies, to help the poor, and that when we do those things, we know a peace that the world cannot give. And whenever we do these things, then the goodness and kindness of Christ our Savior has appeared. But some days, it certainly seems as if we're living in the land of gloom. Certainly 2020 would qualify. And life is never easy, and lately there has been so much suffering in the world. And not just suffering, there's been so much negativity and cynicism out there. People make hateful remarks to one another, or they go onto social media and they spew all kinds of hatred. Some of it even comes from our nation's leaders. Perhaps at times we are so frustrated, we want to respond in kind. But as followers of Jesus, we know that there is no peace in that, to respond to violence with hatred of our own. It doesn't bring peace. You know, that never brings peace. All it means is that we're defeated before we even leave the house. Christ has taught us that the only response that will have a lasting effect on the world is the response of love. And so tonight, we gather and we choose to be living proof that in an often gloomy world, the light still shines and the darkness has not overcome us. But Christmas, of course, is only the beginning. Christmas was the beginning of Jesus' earthly life, and it's the beginning of our faith life. Christmas makes no sense if the next day we return to the old attitudes and the old behaviors. We are called to live every day in the light of Christ, to be that light shining in the darkness. If God has shown his absolute solidarity with humankind through the incarnation, then we in turn have to show our solidarity with others, especially with the poor and the marginalized of this world. We cannot afford to turn our backs on them. This parish has a wonderful track record of caring for the poor. In the 5 months I've been here, I've seen some really wonderful things happen on this campus. Our St. Vincent de Paul Society and other ministries are well known in this area, and they're certainly well known by the Archdiocese. This parish also has a great reputation for taking strong justice stances. Some of you participated in the marches this last summer. Let's keep it going for the next year. We cannot afford to let the gospel of Jesus Christ not take such deep root in us that it guides our every word and our every action. The world needs it too much. So if we were once birds caught up in a snowy, windy night, Christ has led us to safety. It's now our job to let Christ use us to lead other people to safety as well. That's Christmas, and that's the whole point of Christianity. So may we do it. And also, just on a little more personal level, grateful to share this first Christmas with you in this parish. You know, I'm so full of gratitude, and I'd like to wish each and every one of you and your family members a very happy Christmas and a blessed New Year.
You too, Father. Thank you.
Together, let us profess our faith.
sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
In this holy night, the goodness and kindness of Christ our Savior has appeared, and so we offer up with him our prayers and our petitions to the Father.
For the church, and as Christians celebrate the birth of Christ around the world, we may work for stronger unity among Christians. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For governments throughout the world, that they may recognize the rights of the most vulnerable, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are alone during the Christmas holiday, that they may feel the closeness of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the sick, that they may experience the healing touch of Christ as the new year approaches, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, and for those mourning the loss of a loved one, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, we thank you for the gift of your Son. Help us to receive him into our hearts this Christmas night and to share his love with all we meet. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. With your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. With your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink.
Accept the sacrifice of your hands, praise and glory of his name, and the walls of the church.
As we look forward, O Lord, to the coming festivities, may we serve you all the more eagerly for knowing that in them we make manifest the beginnings of our redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Thank you.
are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Mitchell our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you, and your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Thank you.
vigor from celebrating the nativity of your only begotten Son, by whose heavenly mystery we receive both food and drink, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Just a special thank you, of course. Our choir does a beautiful job. This place is beautiful. We continue to pray for all of our brothers and sisters who can't be with us, and we pray for a quick end to this pandemic. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Let us